So first, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. What was it like growing up in Connecticut?
Fucking dog shit. It was so bad. Mm-hmm. It was terrible. I mean, whenever you guys interview somebody that comes from like a small town, they're mm-hmm. gonna tell you the same shit that I'm gonna tell you. And that shit was just ass, waking up every single day, doing the same thing every weekend, mm-hmm. and having nobody interested in the shit that I was interested in. And you would have to like go to the internet to find kids who were interested in the shit that you were interested in. And oh my god, bro, like I remember just every day was just a swarm of Bass Pro Shop hats and Timberlands and fucking Vineyard Vines. It was really bad, but you know what, I'm out of there. Those kids are somewhat okay now. Mm. Wish the best for them. You know, it's terrible to see them every day, but yeah, nah.
Bass Pro Shop hats and Timberlands, that's a combo.
It was a crazy one. Mm. Crazy combo, because these kids were, like, they weren't nan, bro. They were crazy. They would, like, put the, they would do this combo with the goddamn sweatpants inside the boots, and then rock some crazy-ass flannel hoodie combo, like what I'm doing right here. Yeah. And the Bass Pro Shop had it glued to the dome. Never left. On all day. Probably showers with it, too.
Crazy. Wow. What part of Connecticut was this?
This was Fairfield County. I was in a really small, like, farm town area. Mm. But it was, like, again, like, the asshole way of Connecticut.
How big?
Shit, like, 30,000 people?
Yeah, that's small. Yeah. Super, super small.
Super tiny. I think now it's, like, 25,000.
Mm. Who were some of your musical influences growing up?
Oh, my God, there's so many. Jesus, man. It ranges from, like, shit my parents used to play, so, like... Mm. I used to listen to hella, like, Tina Marie and fucking Rick James and A Tribe Called Quest. Wu-Tang was big. My dad's a fucking huge Rick Ross fan, and I stole his iPod when I was, a small child. And I had my dad's iPod. I scrolled through it. It was, like, Nas and fucking, like, Wu-Tang and all kinds of crazy shit on there. And I remember listening to this one song by Rick Ross. It was, like, they call me Big Mitch. Larry Hoover. I was, like, damn, this is... fire. So yeah, nah, my dad was like a heavy rap person. My mom was super into like 80s freestyle and 80s pop music, so I'm exposed to those together. And then later into like my middle school area and my fucking like, because I stopped listening to music in like elementary school and like middle school, but once I got into like end of middle school, like beginning of high school, I found SoundCloud through one of my friend's brothers who like wore a V-Lone hoodie. And he was like, yo, like, my brother just copped this hoodie off this, like, new artist he listens to. Like, you gotta peep this shit. Mm-hmm. And we're in our computer lab in, like, eighth grade, and bro pulls a Playboi Carti Broke Boy music video. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, mind was fucking blown. Mm-hmm. I'm seeing Carti get bopped off in the front seat, and he's, like, he's going crazy. He has, like, all kinds of, like... like shit that I wanted at the time, because I was just like the skate shit. So yeah, that like, Hell Supreme on. I was like, yo, this is that dude. Mm-hmm. And I just kept watching that shit. And I found Uno, and I found Fawny, and I found Carti, and I found the whole entire fucking nine of SoundCloud rappers at the time.
Yeah.
And then I got really into indie music at like my sophomore year of high school. So I would do the rotation of like underground shit and indie music and shit my parents listened to for like. Up until now, yeah.
Where did you go to high school?
I went to high school, if you could quickly censor this, I went to high school in it's a really horrible school, don't want to give them any light.
We'll brush right over that.
Hell yeah.
At what point did you start recording music?
I was 14, and I was super like into that, like, I don't know if like you remember this, but like there was a big ass time of like Joey Badass and Pro Era being like huge. Mm-hmm. And I was such a big fucking Joey Badass fan, bro. I was like drawing 47 on my papers in class and shit like a dickhead. But I had this Guitar Hero mic, like the USB one that came with the like the whole rock set and shit. And I plugged that bitch into my computer and I downloaded Audacity and would put like boom bap beats inside of Audacity and try to like rap my ass off like about my third eye and shit. It was terrible.
That was a fun era. I was a big Pro Era fan as well. I got a big ass fan in capital C's right up there.
That's alright, bro.
I got some Joey ones too. That's so funny to hear.
Nah.
Is it true that you went to the same preschool as Midwxst?
I did go to the same preschool as Midwxst. He was a year younger than me. And I just found that out like 3 weeks ago. His father's on
crazy.
I was like, no fucking way. But wait, yeah, we went to the same preschool.
Where was this?
This was also in Fairfield County. This okay. was like a town over from my town.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you have a great relationship with Glaive. How did you two first meet?
Bro, over the internet. Mm-hmm. Like, I tell this story like 50 million fucking times, but it was in a Discord call. I joined. They were all playing CSGO. I was hopping on to play CSGO with one of my friends that I already knew in there. Mm-hmm. And he kept just talking shit to me immediately. As soon as I joined the call, just straight up started talking shit to me. And I was like, I fucking hate this kid with all my passion. Every blood cell in my body, every like possible bone I have, I was like, I fucking hate this kid. I hate this kid. And then we like privately called each other and played video games. I was like, yeah, he's not that bad, and his music's kind of good. Yeah. And he just fucking, what's it called? He went crazy, and then we went crazy together. Now we're here. Mm. Now we're in this position, which is fucking wild. I wouldn't want to do it with anybody else.
I saw you post a picture once. It was you on a beautiful beach with a McChicken. Can you explain what was going on?
Okay, so I was at a private beach in Malibu. Yeah, Malibu, and it was Point Doom. There's a private beach next to Point Doom, and we just hit McDonald's. I was hungry, OD. We didn't eat all day. And we went to the beach, had the dogs out, and I had the McChicken. I was like, damn, bro, like, I really gotta just, like, document what I'm doing right now, because, like, nobody else is doing this right now. Like, who's out here barefoot, dogging a McChicken, 3 p.m., private beach, Malibu, lifestyle, viral. Like, I gotta handle that. So I took the picture, and then it was just 50%, like, damn, you were that guy, and 50% put socks on.
I'm curious to see as you go through your journey, if like 10, 20 years from now, and you're just this mega music star, if you'll still be on a beach eating McChickens.
Hell yeah. Mm. I like actually don't, like, that's like a pet peeve of mine, when people like change their lifestyle due to money, or they feel like they have to change their lifestyle due to money. Like, you will still catch me buying White Owls if I have like, ooh, what's it called? If I have mad bread, if I have more bread.
No question. All right. Can you explain to me what Ericdoa 2 is?
Ericdoa 2 was a place for me during quarantine to not upload. Like, if I wanted to upload some shit and I wanted to not, like, care about it, like, if I wanted to just bullshit, if I wanted to make a site, if I was manic and I wanted to make some bullshit, I would just throw it on that page. Mm-hmm. And somehow people enjoyed the bullshit that I was putting on that page. Mm-hmm. Just like the rest of the other like SoundCloud accounts I have.
So you, Glaive, and West, and some others have been kind of deemed like the faces of Hyperpop. What are your thoughts on that term to begin with? Because I know some people don't like it, some people do.
Yeah, a lot of people have, you know, their own opinions about it, but I think my thing with it is that I'm 50-50. I'm on the fence, because I feel like labels and terms for music are used for people who haven't listened before to not make them anxious about what they're about to get themselves into. Mm. Because a lot of music listeners are not music listeners like me or music listeners like them or you. It's a person that is extremely normal, like has a very, very, very normal lifestyle and doesn't really understand like the intricacies and like little things of music. So when you put something that's somewhat genreless in someone's face, that blatantly without any like label, they're gonna be like, what the fuck is this? So, you know, when there's a label, I 100% want people to like try to, you know, get out of the box of just regular pop music or whatever music they listen to and try to listen to things. So if they want to call it Hyperpop to feel safe, then fuck, go ahead. But labeling it, not really my shit, because I'm like, we do everything. We like to mix other genres, not just pop music. It could be rap, it could be fucking rock, it could be fucking folk music, it could be fucking all kinds of crazy shit.
Mm. One record of yours that I feel like you displayed a lot of like experimentation on was your Fuck ISIS freestyle. Can we just talk about how that came about?
Wow. I feel like I'm on a Nardwar right now, bruh. Damn. Yeah, so I was 16 years old. Mm. And this was around the time of like, you know, the fucking shitty boys, like, they were popping off crazy. Like, Babytron popping off crazy. Babytron is one of the best rappers of all time. But, yeah, so, like, the whole Shitty Boy shit was going crazy. So, me and then a friend of mine, John, his name, he goes by Chach, we made a song together. And it was just us bullshitting for, like, I'm sure a minute and 45 seconds.
What was your favorite bar of yours on that song?
My, I'm up in Walmart having an anxiety attack is my favorite bar from that song.
Facts.
Yeah.
I like that. What's your favorite bar you've ever said?
Six figures off of
Hyperpop.
Oh, yeah.
What was it?
I said I made six figures off of Hyperpop in a song before.
I like that.
Yeah.
How old are you?
19.
Not many 19-year-olds make six figures, so shout out to you. So, what was the process like recording this EP that you just released with Glaive?
Me and Ash stayed in an Airbnb in like the fucking weirdest area in North Carolina. Mm-hmm. It's like right next to where he lives. It's Asheville. Mm-hmm. And we stayed in like a high elevated mountain area of Asheville. And we stayed in this beautiful house for like 5 days, and every day we'd wake up and we'd make a song together. Mm-hmm. And he was there, another person was there, and then I believe Wheaton. Yeah, Wheaton was there. Mm-hmm. And they would just cook up downstairs, and then we would wait for them to make beats, and we'd listen to them, and then we'd put ideas over it and make full songs. Mm. That was the house we made Cloak and Dagger in, that's the house we had there, it's the house that we made so much shit. Mm.
And now, you're actually on tour with Glaive.
Yeah.
How's it been so far?
Oh, it's been crazy, man. Mm. Like, to see that me and him have, like, our fans just be so excited to see both of us is great. Mm. It's a mixture of his fans, my fans, and then they come together, which is just, for us, it's fire.
Is this your first tour?
Yeah.
What's your favorite part so far?
Favorite part? I think my favorite part was the first show, and then going up to like the merch desk and having everybody flooded. Mm. And everybody be so happy to see like us, and to be happy to like get something signed. Mm. It's really sweet.
What's your least favorite part?
Traveling.
Yeah.
I don't really like traveling. Mm. But I'm getting used to it.
So, one thing I was wondering, why did you get banned off Airbnb?
You want to come help me with this
one?
So,
Lyrical Lemonade Channel. This is Glaive.
Alright, first, introduce yourself.
Hello, I'm Glaive. I'm Eric's producer. Mm-hmm. That's about it, honestly. I produce some other stuff too, but yeah. How did we get banned on Airbnb?
And John, we decided that we were going to take a trip to New York with our other roommate, Nicholas. He's over there. So we decided to take a trip to New York, and I was like, you know what, John? We're out in New York for those 2 months. We're going to get so many fucking placements, and we're going to get playlisted, and we're going to go crazy, and everybody's going to be fucking with us. So what I did, it was I invested all $1,000 I had in my bank account into a Airbnb. And John invested a lot of bread that he had into an Airbnb. Yeah. And went half on it. And everything seemed fine at first. And then I went back to my parents' crib for a little bit in Connecticut just to say what's up to them and just make them believe that nothing was wrong. Mm-hmm. But there was so much. Yeah. So much wrong.
The day he like went back to his parents' house, like the power on our Airbnb went out. And then like I tried to call like the guy who like had the Airbnb, and he ghosted me, he didn't respond. And then I tried to call I don't know if I should say his name.
We're gonna not say his name.
Yeah, call the guy who was trying to get us in. Can you bleep out the name, I guess?
That was a fucking dork, bro.
We tried to call the guy who like let us in. He was like, he came in, he like flipped like two switches, and he was like, yup. And he like left. And then at this point, I'm like, bro, what am I supposed to do? I'm in New York.
He fucking blew mine, because as soon as we walked into the like the Airbnb, he was like, yo, keep it real. Don't let anybody see you come in here through these hours of the day. Plus, if somebody like knocks on the door, say you're staying with me. I was like, he don't own this place. I'm like, this is not real.
And then, like, we contacted Airbnb, we're like, yeah, no power, no nothing. And then, like, They like just banned my account or
they
something.
They were on me. They literally just did, yeah. They banned my shit, his shit, and they thought we were doing fraud, basically.
Yeah.
Because it was like our third day there, and we were like, yeah, like, bro didn't pay the electric bill, like, we're in this bitch, and there's no lights, or I can't see type shit. And I sent them a picture John took of just like blackout, like the apartment, and I'm pretty sure they just thought I covered them.
Yeah, and it was like hot too. It was
a heat wave that week in New York City. Mm-hmm. And shout out to fucking our friend Taylor, because if we didn't have them, she like, she went crazy for us.
Mm-hmm. She was an OD. Yeah, but that was crazy. I had like $200 in my bank account because like, they charged me for another Airbnb, and like that was like literally all my money.
Then we had to cop another Airbnb in Chinatown, bro. Mm-hmm. And yo, I'm telling you, when I went to the bathroom the night that we got there, like, bro, there's like a whole like they had their own like summer smash for cockroaches in the back of the toilet. Yeah.
Damn. I also remember like crazy. we had to get like a hotel like for one of the nights, and we just sat there. We're like. Like, bro, we are literally homeless right now.
Nah, I was so ass. I had no money. I had to, like, beg. I texted his girlfriend to send me money for a bacon, egg, and cheese. It was that bad.
Damn, bro.
And she did. Shout out to, you know what I mean?
She was crazy.
My bacon, egg, and cheese. But, yeah, then I met my manager, and then, because we were in that fucking, what's it called, in that shitty ass, like, Chinatown apartment, until he called, and then when we went to his studio, that's the first time I think me and John got like a hot meal and like water and like actual running water.
It was scary times.
Yeah,
it's fucked.
Now we're here though.
Yeah,
I'm with my dog.
Wait, hold on,
that whole story is fucked.
Yep,
that was wild.
Hey Liam.
Oh,
hey.
What's
going on, dog?
How you doing?
Okay, whatever you guys talk.
Geniuses. So, speaking of Summer Smash, of like cockroaches in New York.
You were turning up.
Yeah. You actually performed at the Lyrical Lemonade Summer Smash earlier this year. How was that experience for you?
That shit was cool as fuck, man. Mm-hmm. I've seen so many things. Well, I've never been to like a real concert before. So, that was like my first like experience like seeing other artists perform and shit like that. And it was so fucking cool.
Like, you had never been to a concert?
Never been to a concert.
Either. That was really? Like the first time.
A concert or a festival?
A concert.
Like a concert.
Like in general.
Like a massive stage. Like, oh, I've been to like random like little like rapper shows and stuff.
I've been to too many of those.
I went to random little rapper shows too.
Like, that was your first time performing then?
That was my first, not really. No, my first time performing in front of a crowd.
Okay.
Like that knew my shit.
Okay, okay.
But, yeah, man, it was a great experience. I got to meet so many people and fucking drink hella 1800 and fucking
just walk Lyrical around. Lemonade.
There was a lot of that.
A lot of 1800 and Lyrical Lemonade, those guys.
Crazy.
For the record, how tall are you? How tall are you?
I got this.
How tall am I?
Yeah, you.
He's you like two. A calm, like.
I'm like a.
Yeah, he's 6'2".
I'm like
6'3".
I'm like a calm, yeah.
No, I was 6'4" when he has the boots on.
Yeah.
These things have been saving my life. I put Dr. Scholl's in these bitches too, so now I'm like 5'9" at least.
Right. He's taller, way taller.
Without the boots, without the Dr. Scholl's, rough ballpark.
Give it like 5'7".
5'7".
Okay. People be wilding on the internet saying I'm like 5'4" or 5'5". Okay. Like, I get it. Like, I'm small. Like, I'll keep it real. I'm a small person. Small built, tiny guy. Yeah. But I'm a decent, like, oh my god, like, no, I'm not like, oh my damn height, but like, I'm like a, he's tiny type of height.
And doing research, that was one question that kept popping up, and I was like, maybe we should just get it settled right
official.
Here.
Like, to put it in the books, to everybody watching, I'm like, damn near 5'7".
Okay.
Damn near.
Are you taller or shorter than Midwxst?
I am shorter than pretty much every artist ever.
Okay. Just
besides a couple.
Who are some artists that you want to work with in the future?
Shit, man. I just saw them recently. East Humor would be fucking insane. There's like a lot of like pop acts that I want to work with. I would love to make some shit with Leroy. I think it'll be fire. And a lot of producers. Mm. I don't want to get them.
And then my last question is, where do you see yourself in 5 years?
5 years? Jesus Christ.
Eat more McDonald's chicken sandwiches and the
beaches? Yeah, we're doing the same shit every year. Mm-hmm. This never changes. We're doing the same shit every year.
Mm.
I got a high halo.